Samurai. This week, you and me, my friend, try to stream a past. Today, I take you out. You're going out. By the way, Samurai, I have a couple of surprises for you that you won't soon forget.
Johnson, I don't know what you're going to be up to this week.
No surprises this week.
I should hope so. I'm Bill Bronson. Today, Samurai takes on the Bad Boy. What do you think about that?
Well, I think that Samurai's going to have his hands full taking on the Bad Boy. But, you know, we'll see what happens.
Let's go down to ringside now because Hollywood is here today. Hollywood steps in the ring against Ninjak. Let's go down to ringside.
This match is scheduled for one fall. From the Tibetan Mountains, weighing in at 260 pounds, Ninjak!
Ninjak, the great wrestler from the Tibetan Mountains.
Great. Great,
great. Great wrestler.
I don't think
so. Moves there, Bronson.
He's so great. How come he hasn't won any matches here in the NPWA, I don't think.
And his competitor,
he's a really athletic competitor.
Hollywood!
Yes, of course. Got to wrestle. Stay to wrestle.
Hollywood.
Yes, indeed.
Whoa! We got explosions taking off here this week for Hollywood.
Yeah, that or eat some beans in the back there. I don't know. It was one of those two. But definitely he's in that ring and fireworks go off.
Pretty smoky beans.
Oh!
This man is incredible.
Look at the size advantage over these two.
This man, Hollywood, is definitely incredible. He is one of the biggest men we've had here in the NPWA, but he's the quickest. Oh, took his head off.
That size advantage, that looks like Webster in the ring there. Oh, I'm not sure who's taller.
Look at him.
Is Vinny Estrada taller than Ninjak?
I don't know, but look at Hollywood. He's just poised, ready for this clothesline or something. What's he going to do? Oh, I guess we know. My goodness.
That man has just drinking too much cappuccino, I think, Bronson. He is upset. Upset. This man is.
Uh-oh. And that scoop and a slam. Couldn't quite get him up. Look at this.
Oh, no.
Something different happened this week.
Oh, at least it's not Mad Mike.
Listen to this. The voice of the NPWA, Scott Oresco.
Well, guys, I'm going to come here for one reason. I'm trying to find Mad Mike.
Mad Mike?
Well, have you seen him at all? I mean, I'm doing all these announcing duties by myself, and where is that?
What's happened to him? I haven't seen him all week.
I know, that's what I'm trying to think.
You know what? I think
you're his best friend.
I think during this show we have some footage that might explain what happened with Mad Mike. You weren't there, but the whole entire NPWA was.
Well, this is ridiculous. This guy's supposed to be a podcast journalist. He's nowhere to be found. I should be here doing his job.
Stay tuned, Scott Oresco. Oh, what a clothesline from your favorite wrestler, Hollywood.
That's another thing. Let's not get my passing down with Hollywood. Hollywood's a great wrestler. I like him.
What do you mean you're
bad? I know where you guys are getting at. I don't want to get too much into it.
Uh-oh. It's all over now.
First of all,
the backbreaker.
First of all, we all know this is indeed Scott Oresco there, right? Also, we also know that the winner here is Hollywood. But we all know that Mad Mike is not my best friend, Scott. I do believe that he's one of your roommates or living lovers or something. I don't know. Anyway, if you go out of the house more often, you would see what happened in this footage we have here. Maybe we all all know where Mad Mike is going to.
Well,
he got the cold feet. He's getting married, you know.
That's right. He announced it last week. Hollywood gets the Duke. Looks like he maybe twitched a muscle in his neck, but he looks fine now.
What?
Victorious.
Dude, I wonder.
What?
He did say someone is going to be his best man. I wonder who that could be.
I wonder. We
heard from Scott. I don't think it's Hollywood anyway, because he clotheslined the blind.
Scott Oresko, he'll be in the back later on today doing an interview with the Samurai upcoming in our next matchup. And we'll see what happens with the Samurai. The Raging Bull. This man has been on a winning streak ever since he's returned to the NPWA earlier this year. Last week, we met Dr. Destruction, and he's been en route to the Connecticut Championship. Dr. Destruction stood in the way as a hitman to protect Death from the threat of the Raging Bull challenging him. So it was no disqualification last week. The Raging Bull met Dr. Destruction. And we all know in the end that once again, the Raging Bull prevailed. Getting a clean pin on Dr. Destruction, the Raging Bull proved once again that he is championship bound. He has one more obstacle to pass to get to the man who has the Connecticut title, Death.
Is that supposed to be your hitman, Death? You want a job done, why don't you come do it yourself?
The Connecticut champion, Death, will be defending the Connecticut state title in a matter of weeks against the winner of the Raging Bull and the man he will take on next week in our top contenders match to determine who will get the title shot against Death. The Raging Bull takes on the Cool Kid. A few weeks back, Death wrestled the Cool Kid and defended his title successfully against him. The Cool Kid wants a rematch, claiming he wasn't really ready for that matchup and he knows now how to beat Death. The Raging Bull wants the rematch. Next week, two close friends battle it out for a shot against Death.
Next week, I'm going to get you in the ring. You may be my friend and all, but it's it. That's over. In the ring, it stops. Me and you, 1-on-1. I want Death more than you could ever want him.
All right. Before we get back to the ring, Gorgeous Gary, we've got some footage. Everybody's been noticing Tom the G as of late. Where's he been? He's been suspended from refereeing in the NPWA.
This is Tom the G live at Hooters, and you know what? Everybody wants me back, even the Hooters people. All the radio stations want me back. Everybody knows that Tom the G is the greatest athlete that ever, ever donned the tights in the squared circle. I'm the greatest manager. I'm the greatest of all time. Hey, as a matter of fact, take a look at this. Here's somebody who really wants me back.
Hi, it's Gary Lee Horn from the 105.9 HCN Morning Show, Pocozzi and the Horn. I'm Gary Lee Horn. This is Michael Pocozzi. You're watching the NWPA Wrestling here. Bring back Tommy G, right? Bring back Tommy
G. Bring back Tommy G.
Yay!
What's up with this NWPA?
Well, he's a radio personality. He doesn't know too much.
I listen to Stern anyway in the morning.
Oh, stop it.
Well, I don't know. I'll tell you, Tommy G, he's a great wrestler, but everybody, indeed everybody, I believe even... Everybody has asked to have Tom the G come back. Even O.J. Simpson has called.
Oh,
him.
God.
Even up from England. Right,
it'll take $1 million to get Tom the G back here. All right, let's go to Scott Oresko.
You know what, Tommy G?
With the Samurai, but first we'll listen to what Serrano, this is what he said a few weeks ago on this situation.
You can dye my shoes. You can iron my clothes. But as far as refereeing goes, I'm suspending you indefinitely. Because let me tell you, my man, it's my NPWA. I want it fair.
You got it, Gary. Good.
All right, fans, big matchup coming tonight. My guess at this time is the Samurai. He's going to be, how you doing, Samurai? Big match against the Bad Boy.
Yeah. Now, you know, it's going to be big in more way than one. But, you know, his partner wasn't all that. You know, that was pretty easy.
Big win.
And, you know, yeah, it was a big win. Hey, thanks for telling me that, man. You know, and as far as his... physically challenged partner, it can't be that hard, you know? And if I could take out both members of the World Tag Team Champions, why can't I have a shot? Why can't I have a title shot?
I'm sure you're getting very close. This is ridiculous. I think Death is ducking you. Death is ducking you. I know that. If you cannot get a title shot after a win, if you can beat the bad boy, you should go to the new commissioner, because we now have Mr. Peters no more. We have a brand new commissioner.
Yeah,
he's very, very intelligent. He's nothing like our past commissioner. Very intelligent man, I think.
Yeah, man, I might just have to do that, you know, because I got to get my shot. You know, I did my time. I'm sitting here fighting my opponent. After today's win, I think it's overdue, you know?
Well, me and you were already cheated out of tag team titles last season. Hopefully now, singles titles, hopefully now, with a win tonight, maybe Death will be next. Hopefully different things will happen.
I don't know, I hope this place shapes up, because I haven't had a belt yet, and I think it's about time I get one.
It's time,
sir. Yeah. All right.
So, congratulations to your win over Executioner, and good luck to you tonight.
Thanks a lot.
Against the bad boy. We'll be back.
All right, thanks, Scott Oresco, for that interview. And we all remember it was 2 weeks ago, right, Gorgeous Gary, when the Samurai put away the Executioner. Now the bad boy wants a piece of him today. Samurai been on a tear.
He's been on a tear. You know, he wants a shot. He wants a title shot. I believe he should have a rabies shot or tetanus shot first.
Hey.
Yeah, this guy was really just a little bit too bold. Wants a title shot. Was he the one that lost to Tom Mahler?
He got the three count. You were questioning about the shoulder being raised, but there you saw it.
That is above the ground there, as you can see.
Oh, all right, now let's go to some interesting footage and find out what happened to Mad Mike, Ultimate Champ, last week. He heard that Hot Body Brown was going to be down at Champs for the pool tournament. He showed up, and when you get those two in the same building, instantly a brawl ensued. Let's take a look down at Champs. What happened? And then Mad Mike gets involved. Even some of the spectators get involved. It was a bad scene.
As you can see, I was not involved in the melee. I was really...
Oh, God! One champ jumps off the...
This is a bad boy.
Look at that.
How long did that guy have? Someone saw his
pressure. Oh, right now. I'll run around. Bad Mike says, oh, my God, still down.
Bad man, right?
The whole entire place emptied out and caught him in the parking lot, chased them all around, and we have not seen Mad Mike since that incident.
Oh. So that's maybe why he's gone, huh?
This match is scheduled for one fall.
It's a possibility.
15-minute time limit.
Could be a possibility.
The Shaolin Temple weighing 280 pounds. The Samurai.
Yeah, I thought I'd say it, Blasio, but it's kind of lonely here without him.
Okay.
Not the same thing.
I think it's great.
And his opponent, one half of the tag team champions from New York City, weighing in at 301 pounds,
I think the bad boy counts more than one half. You know what I'm saying?
Well, he is the stronger half of the team, possibly, many would say. Although, yeah, I don't know. You like the Executioner as well. What do you think? What do you think is the stronger half? I think the bad boy is more representative of the NPWA tag team.
To Tom Waller.
Yeah, that doesn't... We're not going to say nothing about it. was Tom the G as a referee. And
exactly.
But he also lost the account to the bad boy at one point, too. Last year at Connecticut Tournament about this time. But he had the tournament for the initial title, so you've got to...
Wow, how fast time has flown by.
Yes. I'll tell you, we're coming up on our 100th edition of NPWA Wrestling in about, six, seven weeks. And we're going to have a very special show lined up. 100 editions since 1993. The NPWA's been here. We'll have more on the 100th show.
You've been with them all, Bronson. I've been with about at least 75 of them. Maybe 70 of them, but...
You know, it's 70 too many, I believe.
Very good, Bronson. But I'll tell you what they are now. It seems like only yesterday, this was just a little thing. And now everywhere I go, people are always constantly asking me for my autograph. Well, they always ask for my autograph. But, you know, constantly now, people are asking me all about the NPWA. They want to join. They want to be a part of it. You can be a part of it.
Well, I'll tell you what. NPWA, it's definitely not a secret anymore. We just got another letter today from a man. Well, you want to take care of that? Very interesting letter.
Okay. To whom it may concern. My name is John, excuse me if I pronounce this wrong, Calora Jr. from Cromwell, and I enjoy watching your program each and every week. I think you have a great selection of wrestlers, but there is one in particular who I have absolutely no respect for. You see, I am a paramedic student who takes pride in my studies and in the field of emergency medicine. And when I see Dr. Destruction, it just makes me sick. This is no doctor. A doctor is supposed to help out and treat people. This so-called doctor is nothing but a disgrace to the medical field. I'm writing to ask if there's any way for me to give Dr. Destruction a taste of his own medicine. EMT/P, John Calor Jr.
And, having a hard time with that ending there, all those letters.
A, B, C, D, E, M, T, I guess. I don't know, but...
Well, I'll tell you what. Dr. Destruction, I wish I could tell Dr. Destruction about
you know
that,
what?
But we don't speak
guy
cool.
I think this guy is Doogie Howser, if you ask me. I don't know. Dr. Destruction is a licensed medical...
Get out of here!
He isn't... I've seen...
You are full of it.
I've been in his office before. I've seen a diploma from Yale School of Medicine. He went to all the schools. He's got PhDs. He's got bachelors. He's got... everything.
Now you're full of it.
I'm telling you, he's out with those new wave treatment things, you know?
Wait a second. The door is open to the side. Look out. Oh, it's Hot Body Brown. What the heck is he doing out here?
He's watching his match.
Well, thank God Dr. Instruction's not here. At least I don't think so. Because who knows what happened?
Telling the ref how to do his job. That's good.
I think Hot Body Brown's here because of what happened when the Ultimate Champ wrestled Big Bubba Hughes. Remember that? The Samurai got involved. Maybe Hot Body Brown has a sport of something with the Samurai now.
On top of things there, Bronson.
Oh, I just figured maybe that would be the case. You never know with Hot Body Brown. Samurai taking
maybe
care
he's
of that
just
boy.
Trying to be an honest person out there trying to look at his competition for his heavyweight championship title he has around his waist. He wants to see how they're wrestling.
Well, Hot Body Brown and a bad boy, I don't think they get along too well. I know Hot Body Brown has no liking for the Samurai. Maybe the Ultimate Champ will show up. I don't think he's here. Well, he could be. You never know.
You never know with the Ultimate Champ.
Oh, what a fly.
He seems to always be around. He's like a bad penny. He keeps turning up, you know. He's definitely around somewhere.
The cover. One, two. Bad boy rolls out of there. And I mean rolls. This guy has got to get down to World's Gym. I don't know how many times we got to tell him. Look at him. He's so disgusting. Look.
I tell you, you know, I do believe that he won. One time he entered a Mr. Universe title, and he did win it. Of course,
the whole universe
was trying to who looked most like a universe. And that was indeed the...
Never heard of that kind of
well,
guy.
That's what I heard. I'm not too sure.
One, two, uh-oh. Hot Body Brown pulled the Samurai out from the pin attempt. The Samurai didn't like that one.
You got to remember something here, though.
Referee Richie Eldridge putting the count in.
Oh, man. We got too many referees in this...
Uh-oh.
Where's Tom the G? He should be a referee, I'm telling you.
Well, Hot Body Brown should not be interfering, and the bad boy cinches up a figure four, and wait a second. Ah! So look who's coming out now!
I'd rather not.
Ultimate Champ saw what's going on. He's helping out his friend, the Samurai.
The Ultimate Champ runs like he just ate a bunch of X-Lax bars.
Oh, what a kick. Never heard of those kind of kicks.
I think he's been down a Taco Bell. He's just...
Hey, where are they going? They're going in the ring. We got a match going on. These two guys are going in the ring. Brawl, what?
Now, how unprofessional.
Get them out of
the
ring.
Ultimate Champ.
Look,
Hot Body Brown just stayed outside the ring minding his own business. And here comes the Ultimate Champ.
Uh-oh.
Got to get involved.
Referee's
still
lost.
In limelight.
Referee is lost in this one. And a back body drop. Oh, my goodness. It's out of control here. Bad boy's going crazy. He's going to hit the referee.
This is a pure six brawl.
What does the referee do in a situation like this?
I say he steps out of the ring.
I think the bell's been called and referee's starting to take
it down. Tom the G was there,
chicken wing being applied by the bad boy.
Chicken wing?
He's got a chicken wing on the Samurai.
Oh, no, you can't eat that bad boy. You just can apply it.
Look.
The man is.
Dr. Destruction's here. We were just reading a letter about him. I had no idea he was here. Oh, no.
You want to go down and tell me that real doctor now?
Huh? I
he's a real doctor.
Well, Kalua or whatever his name was that wrote that letter. Oh, no.
Kalua wrote that letter. He's Dr. Scholes, I'll tell you that much.
Hot Body hit the post shoulder first, and this deck is out of control.
He doesn't know Dr. Destruction from Dr. Pepper, I'm telling you right now. Oh. That is indeed a doctor in that ring. And look at this, I mean.
What do you mean? Oh. Doctor. Yeah, with sandals on, give me a break.
Dr. Scholes, you ever hear that?
Three guys!
We
gotta stop! Three on two! Where's some help? Somebody! We need officials, we need something.
Why? Do we need officials?
Wait a second!
Oh,
the referee's down there in Hollywood!
It's got a wrestler's fair wrestler!
Hollywood in the ring! Hollywood is coming! Back body drop! Oh!
He just cleared a big...
Oh!
No, look, he cleared a house!
No! He's a one-man gang in there! Bouncing off him like a ping pong ball.
He's like a 34-year-old housewife. He's just cleaning house. I'm telling you, he's just got a broom and a mop and a vacuum cleaner, and he's going off in that ring.
He cleared the ring, and he helped the Samurai and the Ultimate Champ. And I don't know what the decision is. I guess this match is thrown out. I don't know. Samurai. Well, the. I know the Samurai didn't win, but I don't think anybody won this match.
Samurai's music. It don't matter.
What was settled here? I don't know. Well, we got six men that want a piece of each other. What do you do in this situation? It looks like they're taking off.
Well, I don't
That's
know.
A weird threesome if I've ever seen one.
Well, I've seen weirder ones, but not in the ring.
Let's go to the replay. Tried for his power bomb that he's been using on his opponents for weeks. Couldn't quite get the Samurai up that time. This is really
tough. You see the
foot race.
Oh, yeah, right. With what? The turtle and the hair?
And the back body drop. This is when the referee had no choice but to call this match out. Too much going on. Bad boy applies a chicken wing. A chicken wing of all maneuvers. Dr. Destruction shows up. Rich Eldridge, our official, goes out of the ring. 3-on-2.
Until.
Man, wait a second. Gorgeous Gary, everybody's coming back into the ring. Wait a second. We've got action in the ring. This is just a replay. Let's go back to the ring.
Oh, come on.
We've got Hot Body Brown to bat. We got all six of them going at it in the ring now, almost.
Come on, technicians, get down. I want to see this.
They're showing a replay. I'd want to see the ring. I don't want to see the replay.
This live?
They're going at it.
Is this live?
We are live. That's why there's a problem with our technicians. Man, Mike must be running the show here. Let's go to the ring. Here we go. Throw it in. Come on. Here we go. Six men are back. Bailing it out again. Control.
out of control. Where's Scottaresco to go break these things up?
Oh, we saw him walk into the ring a few weeks ago. That was when the Samurai, thankfully, came up to his aid. Hot Body Brown was out there. Oh, Hot Body goes down. We've got to get some control. The referee's back in there trying to control it. What? Well, almost. Didn't work again. I don't know, Gorgeous Gary. Something's got to be done. We're running out of time here this week in the NPWA.
You got to ban Hollywood.
Oh!
He shouldn't be down there.
Hot Body
Chris
falls out
even fight.
We've got a PS6 belt backer stretches at his chair. No! Best man, you never know, he said somebody here. No, I don't think so, never, not me. We'll talk about it next week. Next week's top feature match, the cool kid takes on the Raging Bull, and the winner gets a shot at the Connecticut champion Death.
And Lessons is doing interviews,
plus we'll maybe have a report on the six-man situation we just saw in the ring. Who knows, that match might happen. Who knows? This just in addition to next week's top contenders match between the Raging Bull and the Cool Kid, the Ultimate Champ will team up with the Samurai as his partner, and their partner will be the man known as Hollywood in a six-man tag team matchup war. Will be promised next week against the unlikely duo of Dr. Destruction, one half of the NPWA World Tag Team Champions, the Bad Boy, and their partner, NPWA World Heavyweight Champion, Hot Body Brown. We'll have it for you right here next week on NPWA Wrestling.